This is the part two of our video from Summit Junction to Asaba Head Bridge and back. In the part one video, the travel time from Summit Junction to Asaba Head Bridge and back was roughly 26-27 minutes, because it was the shot was done at about 5:40 a.m. in the morning when the roads were quiet. So now let's look at the travel time from Summit Junction to Onitsha Head Bridge and back. The time now is 11:50 a.m. Ahead, we're getting close to Summit Junction now from the filling station on Sherry filling station. The roads are beginning to be more congested because the cars parked on the right hand side, and van is about to move, and a pedestrian pushing a wheelbarrow. We're already 2 minutes into the journey. The last time it took us 2 minutes from Summit to the filling station on the right, Northwest filling station, or gas station as the case may be. Also look at the activities of these mini buses that ply the express and how they tend to stop indiscriminately. So it took us 3 minutes to Northwest filling station. So we're getting to the first turning point that was being problematic the last time, which is fine fuel filling station turning point. Traffic is beginning to build up gradually here. But look at the left hand side, you know, vehicles coming from Onitsha. You see, you can see the problem of on the other side. Now, this is one of the solutions to the problem, which is to allow traffic going to Onitsha to move freely. That turning point should be blocked to cars turning round at that point going to Wori, Ogwashuku and the rest. But what that does is that, you know, it still holds the traffic up here. So from the fine field filling station turning point, you see the traffic hold up is intense on the other side of the road for vehicles coming from Onitsha. that turning point is as far as to the road safety, traffic holdup, I believe so. Now when that happens, you find out that the commercial buses coming from Onitsha tend to get onto this lane and drive dangerously by driving against traffic. Stopping on the right hand side by that bus, making things difficult for everybody. It's taking up 5 minutes to road safety. Which is not bad, ideally. Because of the traffic that is going to be on the Usak end of the junction based on park trucks, taxis and commercial motorcycle riders, I was trying to maintain the left lane, but because of this guy that is indicating to turn, I had to return back. See if we're gonna have a yep, we can overtake this. We need to return back to the left lane because of the traffic that is building up on the right hand side. Seven minutes to the Bonsack end. Close to MTN. See, those commercial vans parked there is not necessary. That truck that is parked there is also not necessary. The work van there is not necessary. This truck here too shouldn't be parked there. Motorcycle going against traffic. Another back. Up one, two back trucks just on the highway. In opposing traffic. So MTN were there at the 8 minutes. Mostly public holiday, the volume of traffic ideally is supposed to be reduced. So we're going to try one of those days, working days, and see the difference. Another turning point here which can be a bit problematic. regarding to the Oakway Estate Junction. Junction took us 11 minutes.
The Bible says that we are inscribed in the palm of His hand. And heaven and earth may pass away, but His word will remain forever. And He can do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we can ever ask.
Now, from here to the head bridge, let's see how long it's going to take us. And unscheduled stops carried out by this commercial bus drivers. No one is compelled to using the left lane. So I'm going to be turning around at the head bridge. I'll maintain this lane so that I don't obstruct traffic. Towing vehicle is confused, doesn't know what he's doing. Doesn't know what he's doing, so he's all over the place. Got into the NRTW motor park, where you tend to have the touts. They are now sat waiting for their prayer. So this portion of the road has been reconstructed, so it is smooth. So this reduces our travel time. Lane, because I'll be turning around soon. So let's see, because the road has been constructed, let's see the cause of this problem here. Spent 15 minutes already. Oh no, we are not yet at the turning point. Now with this good road, now this is where the issue of traffic management comes in. So the various agencies involved in traffic management should be involved in the control of traffic. That's what she means. South LGA Tax Force that just went by. Stand still and I, like, I can see some road safety officials in front, I believe. The inpatients we're talking about, you know, so this pathfinder to maintain one lane, they're trying to create double lanes here. Done 20 minutes now. We're barely at the turning point. What is actually holding up these trucks here is this checkpoint. Waiting. I am not packed. Liberal Motors now towards town. So, because it's possibly because it's a public holiday, the roads appear to be freer. Thank you. almost get into Oakway Government Housing Estate Junction. Compass and as we're heading towards the Abraka Market.
Thank you.
on SAC now, heading towards road safety. Close to road safety now. Those pedestrians crossing. Road safety turning point. Let's see, we're there at about 12:46. Let's see how long it's going to take us to get through this point here. Junction.
Yeah.
10 minutes from road safety, not yet at Farmfield turning point. Can't find my phone down, my friend. Right hand side, another one on the right there, two of them. Thank you. just this bad portion of the road that is causing all this problem, to be honest. So the non-movement of the vehicles as a result of this. Survival of the fittest in driving this portion, which is a bit shameful, to be honest. So two cars are 22 minutes from road safety. Farmfield turning point, all because of the bad weather. 22 minutes. The first video, it took us 27 minutes from Summit Junction to the Head Bridge and back. Got into the end of the round trip from Summit Junction to Head Bridge and back. So unlike the one that started at 5:40, which took about approximately 26 minutes, this round trip on Monday, the 11th, a mostly public holiday, took approximately 1 hour. So we're going to carry out another one during the week and see how long it takes. Maybe at about, we'll start that journey at about say at 3 p.m. and let's see how long it's going to take us to get back this point.